Hi. Did you know that in Angular, you can react to key up or key down events of a particular key on your keyboard by using the following syntax? Cool, isn't it? But what if I tell you that this is not some built-in Angular magic and you can create your own custom events like this? Watch this video until the end and you will learn what are Event Manager and Event Manager plugins in Angular and how to create your custom plugin that will be intercepting certain events in your application and automatically prevent default behaviors. My name is Dmytro Mrzenski and I create advanced tutorials and courses helping others to become advanced experts in this awesome framework. And now let's continue and tackle another advanced Angular feature like Event Manager plugins. Let's get started. All right. Let's take a quick look at the project that I prepared for this particular tutorial. And it consists of one simple web form where users can provide their email and clicking the subscribe button, they can subscribe to newsletters or some other updates, whatever. Right now, the problem is that whenever I click the subscribe button, the page reloads, which is default behavior and it is expected, but it is not what I want to achieve because it breaks my form submission handling logic. Usually we fix this issue by calling the prevent default method on a particular event to prevent default actions. And there's nothing wrong with this solution. However, we often have dozens of such use cases in our apps, and this approach doesn't always scale well because it is quite annoying to add this logic repeatedly, especially if it is something more complex than just one single line of code. In my situation, it also causes some additional boilerplate because I have to provide an event object to the submission handler solely to prevent the default behavior. Fortunately, we can achieve this in a more declarative and clean way. But before I show you the solution, let's take a high-level overview of how Angular event listening and event handling works under the hood. It is important to understand that event binding syntax in component templates doesn't directly bind event listener to elements. There are a few crucial things that happen in between. Namely, there sits a so-called event manager that works as an additional abstraction layer, delegating the actual binding of elements with corresponding event listeners to specialized plugins that can handle a specific task. For instance, listeners for standard events like clicks, submit, input, etc., they are managed by default DOM events plugin. In contrast, the specific keyup event of a particular key, as you saw in the video introduction, it is handled by a dedicated key events plugin. The good news is that this plugin ecosystem is scalable, which means that you can extend it and bring your custom plugin that will bring some unique logic. So, how can we achieve that? First of all, you have to define the syntax of your custom event. For example, let's say that I want to use the following syntax where the word before the dot, it is actual event I want to listen to, and the string after the dot, it is a modifier that indicates which action has to be performed. Once we have that, we can go and create a separate file somewhere in your application, which you can name as you want, and you can place this file whenever it makes sense for you. And from this file, I'm going to export a new class that I name prevent default event plugin. And this class must properly extend a special abstract class called EventManagerPlugin that will require you to implement a few methods, namely supports and add event listener. For now, let's omit the purpose of those methods and simply return dummy values from them as it is required by the corresponding abstract class we extend. So for the supports method, let's return false And for the event listener, let it be just an empty function. And let's also add console logs to both of those methods just to see at which point each of them is called. All right, we are done with this part. And even with this dummy implementation, this plugin could actually be used. But first, we have to properly register our custom event plugin. And we can do it inside the app.config.ts file. And here, among other providers, I'm going to add a new one where I provide the Event Manager plugin injection token that must be configured as a multi-provider. And one of the values for this token will be an instance of my custom plugin class that I just created. And now we can test our plugin and observe the output inside the console. So as you can see, we have received a message from the supports method indicating precisely which event has been intercepted. However, we didn't receive anything from the addEventListener method, which means that this method wasn't called at all. To understand why it happens so, we have to understand the purpose of each of these methods. So the role of supports method is to inform the event manager if this particular plugin can handle a given event. If it returns false, the plugin activation is skipped for this event. However, when it returns true, then the event manager will activate this plugin by calling its addEventListener method. So if you look at the browser console again, you will see a second message from the addEventListener, which means that this plugin for this particular event has been activated. Obviously, I don't want to hardcode the return value for the supports method of my plugin because otherwise it will be applied to every event in my application. So instead, I will quickly check if the event name ends with the .prevent string and activate this plugin only in that case. Great. So this will ensure our plugin is activated only for the appropriate event. Now, let's focus on the addEventListener method and its responsibilities. So this method is responsible for proper registration of the event listener to particular DOM element. But first, let me quickly explain all the arguments here. So the argument element, it is the DOM node where we bind the event in the component template. The event name argument, it is a name of the event. So basically the same what we get for the supports method. And the handler argument for this method, it is a callback function that we defined in our event binding in the component template. So it means that I have actually everything to create a proper event binding for this DOM element. And to do that, I just call a native addEventListener method. And here I have to provide the event I want to listen to. And this is a bit tricky part because here inside the event name, I get actually the name of my custom event, which includes the event itself and a certain modifier. However, I'm only interested in listening to the original submit event. And I can easily get it by splitting the full name of my event by the dot character. And it will give me an array of two strings, where the first string, it will be the actual event name, right? And then I will use precisely this original event as an argument for the addEventListener method. The second argument here should be a callback function that takes an event object, which will be fired sometime later. And this callback is supposed to perform certain logic. But which logic? Obviously, the one we defined in the component template when we created the event binding. So that's why I'm going to simply call the handler function inside this callback and provide the event object as an argument. And at this point, we will achieve pretty much the same behavior as if it would be handled by the default Angular Event Manager plugin. But if you remember, we also wanted to prevent default behaviors for the event. So where do we add this custom logic? And you can do it right here inside the event listener callback before or after calling the handler function, depending on your use case. But actually, this is pretty much it. This means that now we should see the proper work of our plugin in action. So let's try to fill out the form by providing some valid email. And now I'm going to submit it. And as you can see, this time my page is not being reloaded, even though I don't explicitly call prevent default method for the arised event in the onSubmit handler, because my event was intercepted by my event plugin and properly handled. However, despite it working, we just introduced a memory leak that potentially might be dangerous for your application later. What are memory leaks, why they are so dangerous, and how to debug and fix them, you can learn from my previous video. And if you enjoy the current one, consider to subscribe to my channel to not miss the future videos about Angular. But anyway, why do we have the memory leak? In my case, the memory leak is caused by adding an event listener that is not being removed when the corresponding DOM element is destroyed. And the proper place where you can perform cleanup logic and remove the event listener is exactly the function that your addEventListener method returns. So here I have to use removeEventListener method and provide a reference to the callback that has to be removed. And for that, we have to extract the callback function into a constant or anything like that, and then use it as an argument for the add and remove event listener methods, just like that. Alternatively, you could also use the add event listener of the event manager that your plugin inherits from the base abstract class. But this will require some small changes in our syntax, because this method requires also the DOM element that we have to provide, and the rest is the same. We have to provide the event we want to listen to and the callback that has to be executed when this event happens. And by the way, you can provide it without extracting the function into separate constant, just provide it like that. In this case, the event manager will delegate the registration of the event listener to the next plugin, which is in our case will be the default plugin that can handle simple events like submit, click, etc., etc. But it will provide our modified callback function. And this default event plugin, it will properly register it and will properly unregister it and will return the proper cleanup function that we eventually return from our custom event plugin. And in such a way, we will perform cleanup and everything will be just fine. All right, so this is how you can use Event Manager and Event Manager plugins in order to bring some custom and reusable logic into your event handlers. Do you have any ideas where exactly in your application you could apply this technique? If yes, please share your thoughts in the comments and let's inspire others. You can explore this topic even more in depth if you are supporting me on Patreon or here in YouTube membership program, because I'm going to release very soon a series of exclusive videos where I dive into the entire architecture and source code of this plugin system And separately, I will release another video that shows how you can bring RxJS in your custom event manager plugins and how you can create debounced events, for example. If it sounds interesting to you, you can join this program right now, but otherwise, thank you for watching this video until the end. Please share this video if you find this video useful. Hit like if you enjoyed this tutorial, and I wish you a productive week ahead. Stay safe and see you in the next video.